to tell the story will be my theme in glory. To tell the old, old story of Jesus and his love. I love to tell the story, 'tis pleasant to repeat. What seems each time I tell it, more wonderfully sweet. I love to tell the story, for some have never heard the message of salvation from God's own holy word. I love to tell the story, 'twill be my theme in glory. To tell the old, old story of Jesus and his love. I love to tell the story for those who know it best. Seem hungering and thirsting to hear it like the rest. And when in scenes of glory I sing the new, new songs, will be the old, old story that I have loved so long. I love to tell the story, 'twill be my theme in glory. To tell the old, old story of Jesus and his love. Jesus, draw me ever nearer as I labor through the storm. You have called me to this passage, and now follow, though I mourn. May this journey bring a blessing. May I rise on wings of faith at the end of my heart's testing. With your likeness led me way. Jesus, guide me through the tempest. Keep my spirit stayed and sure. When the midnight meets the morning, let me love you even more. May this journey bring a blessing. May I rise on wings of faith at the end of my heart's testing. With your likeness led me way. Let the treasures of the trial form within me as I go. At the end of this long passage, let me leave them at your throne. May this journey bring a blessing. May I rise on wings of faith at the end of my heart's end. fellowship, what a joy divine, leaning on the everlasting arms. What a blessedness, what a peace is mine, leaning on the everlasting arms. Safe and secure from all alarms. Leaning on Jesus, leaning on the everlasting arms. Oh, how sweet to walk in this pilgrim way, leaning on the everlasting arms. Oh, how bright the path grows from day to day, secure from all alarms. Leaning on Jesus, leaning on the everlasting arms. What have I to dread? What have I to fear? Leaning on the everlasting arms. I have blessed peace with my Lord so near, leaning on the everlasting arms. Leaning on Jesus, safe and secure from all alarms. Leaning on Jesus, leaning on the everlasting arms.
Just across on the evergreen shore, sing the song of Moses and the Lamb I invite, and dwell with Jesus evermore. O'er all those wide extended plains shines one eternal day. There God the Son forever reigns and scatters night away. We will rest in the fair and happy land, just across all the evergreen shore. Sing the song of Moses and the Lamb I invite, and dwell with Jesus evermore. Filled with delight, my raptured soul would hear no longer say, though joy in its waves around me roll, fearless I'd launch away. We will rest in the fair and happy land, just across all the evergreen shore. Sing the song of Moses and the Lamb I invite, and dwell with Jesus evermore.
There is beyond the azure blue a God concealed from human sight. He tinted skies with heavenly hue and framed the worlds with his great might.
There is a God, he is alive, and he relieves, and we survive.
And we survive from the star God created man. He is our God, the great I am.
There was a long, long time ago a God whose voice the prophets heard. He is the God that we should know, who speaks from his inspired word.
There is a God,
he is alive,
in him we believe, and we survive.
And we survive from the star God.
Search they cannot find, for God alone does understand.
There is a God,
he is alive,
in him we believe, and we survive.
And we survive from the star
God.
Sin might set men free, and evermore with him could live.
There is a God,
he is alive,
in him we believe, and we survive.
And we survive from the star God created man. He is our God,
the kingdoms of earth pass away one by one, but the kingdom of heaven remains. It is built on a rock, and the Lord is its king, and forever and ever he reigns.
It shall stand
forever and ever.
It shall stand
forever and ever. Amen and amen. The
tempest may rage and its anger acclaim, yea, the wind and the torrents may roar, and the strong gates of hell may assail it in vain, still the kingdom shall stand evermore. It shall stand,
it shall stand,
it shall stand,
it shall stand
forever and ever. And ever
it shall stand
forever and ever. Amen and amen. The kingdom of God is now open to all thee, the vilest may now enter in. There's a welcome for all who will turn to the Lord for salvation and pardon for sin. It shall stand,
it shall stand,
it shall stand,
it shall stand
forever and ever and ever.
It shall stand,
it shall stand,
it shall stand,
it shall stand,
it shall stand
forever and ever. Amen.
Sands of time are sinking, the dawn of heaven breaks. The summer morn I've sighed for, the fair sweet morn awakes. Dark, dark hath been the midnight, but dayspring is at hand. And glory, O Christ, He is the fountain, the deep sweet well above. The streams on earth I've tasted, more deep I'll drink above. There to an ocean fullness His mercy doth expand. And glory, glory dwelleth in Emmanuel's land. The King there in His beauty without a veil is seen. It were a well-spent journey, though seven nets lay between. The His fair army doth on Mount Zion stand, and glory, glory dwelleth in Emmanuel's land. The bright eyes, not her garment, but her dear bridegroom's face. I will not gaze at glory, but on my King of grace. Not at the crown He giveth, but on His pierced hand. The Lamb is all the glory of Emmanuel's land.
Told Joshua to go to Jericho and to march seven times around. He followed faithfully the blessed Lord's command, and the walls came tumbling down.
Yes, the walls,
yes, the walls,
yes, the walls,
yes, the walls came tumbling down.
Joshua,
Joshua,
Joshua marched seven times round.
Then the walls,
then the walls,
mighty
walls came tumbling down, and the walls came tumbling down. If you are trusting in the power of the blood, and you hope to wear a crown, go forward quickly and obey the holy word. Walls of doubt will tumble down.
Yes, the walls.
Yes, the walls.
Yes, the walls.
Yes, the walls came tumbling down.
Joshua.
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 Marched seven times round.
Then the walls.
Then the walls.
Mighty
walls came tumbling down. And the walls came tumbling down. The Lord is calling, sinner, come to Him today. Turn from this vain world's renown. If you will follow Him in faith like Joshua, walls of sin will tumble down.
Yes, the walls.
Yes, the walls.
Yes, the walls.
Yes, the walls came tumbling down.
Joshua.
Joshua.
Seven times round.
Then the walls.
Then the walls.
Mighty
walls. Came tumbling down. And the walls came tumbling down.
Tumbling down, Joshua.
Okay, muli magandang umaga sa inyong lahat, sa ating mga kapatiran at kaibigan sa Countryside Baptist Church. This is our Sunday School ministry at ito po ay gawain ng ating CBC Pasig. So, salamat po sa biyaya ng Panginoon na patuloy po tayo na binibiyayaan niya sa ating mga pangangailangan. Dali lang, titingnan ko lang yung audio ko.
Okay, muli magandang umaga sa inyong...
Okay, I think my audio is clear, no? So you could comment on our Baptist Ministerial Seminary comment box, no? Kung okay yung ating audio. So para malaman ko rin kung... I need to adjust the audio. Okay? So far, ito na yung optimum audio na pwede ko i-calibrate. Hoping walang mga echo, no? So, just message on the comment box kung may mga problem tayo sa audio. Okay, salamat sa Panginoon. Tayo po ay nasa 6-4 na. We're looking into the biblical understanding of church leadership. At tayo po ay nagpapatuloy. Nagsimula tayo sa konsepto ng leadership. It's a very important concept, a biblical concept. Now, starting from the creation mandate, and the Lord also delegated authorities for us, the government, the church, the home, and other authorities, no? Even our employment or school, and other areas wherein there is a leadership mandate ay yan po ay kaloob sa atin ng Panginoon. At ang response natin bilang mga anak ng Diyos ay patuloy na magpasakop at sundin ang ating leadership, no, for the Lord. No, so yan po yung ating napag-aralan. Nakita rin natin si Yahweh bilang shepherd at nakita rin natin ang katuparan nito sa Panginoong Kristo bilang isang dakilang pastor ng ating iglesia, no? And also we preview on the qualification of the elders of the church. Now we'll be making some details as we have read. I suppose you already read on 1 Timothy chapter 3 verse 1 to 7. No, yan po yung ating mga talata na babasahin ngayon. So sana nabasa na natin siya. Okay, so as an introduction, what kinds of things qualify people for leadership in business, no? So it could be in business or local community or in the government. So of course, a government, we're governed by the local government code, no? Hindi ka lang basta pumasok diyan at ano ka na, nasa gobyerno ka na, no? There are some qualifications, minimum requirements or minimum age requirements, no? I would say, and other things, no? Also in the local community ay makikita rin po natin 'yan. For a while lang po.
Leadership in business, no? So it could be...
Okay, so still my audio is clear as of the moment, no? So hoping na magtuloy-tuloy na ito. Okay, so sa business din, dapat, no, importante yan, yung, lalo na yung mga may skills, entrepreneurial skills ang kailangan dyan, no? Doon sa business, of course, some of you are BA major, business major, no? You have, if you're gonna put a business, no, meron tayong mga feasibility study na ginagawa upang sa gayon ay makita rin natin, at the end, we could compute for the ROI or return of investment, no? Ano yung time na gugugoli natin sa investment, and then we will mababawi natin yun or tutubo tayo, no? So these are some things, no, na makikita natin. But yeah, no, yun yung makikita natin, may mga qualification sila, no? Hindi lang tayo basta-basta papasok diyan ang wala man lang mga skills, walang training. Yung mga ating educational attainments also important, as well as our yung ating continuing professional development, no, lalo na sa mga professions, no? So may mga proposal na tanggalin na itong CPD natin, at ngunit ganun pa man, my point is that these people needs to be qualified, no, in terms of business, no, or local community, no, even in the government, no? As my, in my case, as a professor of various universities and colleges, no, I need to have a certain minimum qualification for me to become a professor or instructor, no. So may mga academic attainment, training, no, etc., management experience as well, no. So lahat ng bagay na 'yan ay tinitingnan if that person is qualified for that position of leadership. So what do you think qualifies someone for spiritual leadership in the church? No, as we applied in a local church context, maliwanag yung mga talata o teksto na ating babasahin regarding sa tagubili ni Pablo sa mga kay Timothy, no, how to handle the church, no, what are the characteristics of a leader, no, particularly the elders and then the deacons of the church na in-specify dito. But 6-5, lecture 6-5 will dig into the deacons, but now we will look into the elders, no, qualification of elders. So mahalaga itong mga talatang ito kasi ito rin yung sukatan ng disqualification. If there are these are items of qualification, so these are also items of disqualification for those who have not met these requirements, no, na may kita natin dito sa iglesia na ni Timothy, no, kay Timothy. At of course this also apply to modern New Testament churches, no. So inisa-isa ni Pablo ito, hindi nakakabigla yung qualification because this is also exhorted to the individual believers in other passages of the scriptures except for one, which is apt to teach, no? May teaching skill dapat yung isang magnanais na magkaroon o mukupa ng opisina ng pagka-ubispo o pastor sa isang iglesia. By the way, the concept of calling ay makita natin yan sa tatlong bahagi, no? Of course, it's a transaction between God and the man of God, no? So nasa sense ng tao yon na tinawag siya sa perhaps pagpapastor ng isang church, no? So that's one of the component of calling. And then between the man and the word, so dapat makita niya yung qualifications niya dun sa scriptures mismo, hindi lang nagising ka isang araw at kala mo tinawag ka ng papastor, naginip ka kasi na tinawag ka, no? Hindi ganun ng concept ng calling. So it's between you and God, dapat ay matukoy mo ito na ito nga ay tunay na panawagan sa'yo, and then between you and the scriptures, no? So maraming mga explicit texts na makikita yung ating mga qualifications o yung mga katangian ng isang pastor sa iglesia. And then lastly, the third component between you and the congregation. Did the congregation recognize if you already have the calling, that's number one, and then you have the qualifications, no? So parang ito yung checklist mo eh. And then number three, the recognition of the local church. No, napakahalagang bagay niyan, no? Kasi magkakaproblema kung wala yung isa doon. No, pag walang calling ng Diyos, no, talagang wala yon, no? Does not make sense, no? Ay iba tumawag sa iyo siguro, sarili mo o ibang tao, no? And then yung number two, word of God, hindi kung wala ka namang hindi nag yung skill set mo hindi nag-match doon sa qualifications na sinasabi ng teksto ng salita ng Diyos, no? You're being unfaithful to the word, therefore disobedient. No? So hindi rin tama 'yon, napipilit mo 'yung sarili mo, wala kang mga katangian ganun. And then pangatlo, masisense kasi ng congregation yung leadership skills mo, leadership mo sa ministry mo sa iglesia, dapat i-recognize 'yon. So ito 'yung tatlo, no? Hindi lang basta tinawag ka ay yun na, no? So meron tayong tatlong component between you and God, no? That's a transaction between you and the Lord. If you are been called, convinced by the Holy Spirit perhaps, no? Because you have seen your qualification, no? Match on the text of the scriptures, no? Importante 'yon. No? This is not a call for perfect compliance but more on the faithfulness. No, yung ating faithfulness, progressive functional holiness na tinatawag, yung progressive sanctification, and then yung recognition ng church, no. Definitely as the Lord guide you, he will also guide the congregation to recognize you, no. So yun yung tatlong yun. It's part also of our congregational form of government, no, lalo sa pag pagtitingin, no, o yung as we look into the leaders of the church, the congregation needs to recognize these skills. Okay? So, ito yung tanong, no? So, sasagutin natin maya-maya ito. Now, the elders must be a man of consistency, consistently exemplary Christian character. So, yung importante yung character. Yung mga pag-uugali, no? Na dapat makita rin ng kongregasyon na pamumunuan niya. Now, must lead their families well, no? So dapat makita rin yung pamumuno sa kanyang tahanan na kung ito nga ay maayos. And then lastly, must be able to teach God's word. Now, aside from the teaching, all of these are actually characters of a Christian. Now, because other passages of Paul sa kanyang mga ibang sulat ay nababanggit 'yon. No? Aside from the teaching of God's word, na kailangan talagang maging character, katangian ng isang mangangaral ng Diyos, isang tatawaging pastor ng iglesia. So importante ito, hindi pwedeng pastor hindi ka marunong mag-preach o wala kang yung skill set mo ay hindi pang preacher. No? May mga preacher na magaling magkwento, magpatawa, pero pagdating sa preaching ay wala. No, so hindi siya pwedeng ma-qualify dito because he must be able to teach God's word, meaning expositionally and exegetically expose God's word, preaching God's word to the congregation and be able to communicate it. No? So yung communication skills ay importante din. Because of course teaching is a communication skills. One of the communication skills na masasabi natin, no? Of course, so let's look now at 1 Timothy chapter 3 verse 1 to 7. From time to time, I'll be commenting on each of the qualifications. Ay makikita natin 'to. Ipaparallel natin based on the text, no? Okay, let's read. So I know you have your Bible handy with you, but I also have my slide. Hindi ko na in-invite yung ating English reader, no? Kasi napagod daw siya last Sunday sa kakabasa. Okay. It is a true saying, if a man desire the office of a bishop, he desired a good work. Verse 2, a bishop then must be blameless, the husband of one wife, vigilant, sober, of good behavior, given to hospitality, apt to teach, not given to wine, nor striker, not greedy or filthy lucre, but patient, not a brawler, not covetous. One that ruleth well his own house, having his children in subjection with all gravity. For if a man know not how to rule his own house, how shall he take care of the church of God? Napaka-importanting tanong yan. No? Verse 6, not a novice, lest being lifted up with pride, he fall into the condemnation of the devil. Moreover, he must be a good report of them which are without, lest he fall into reproach and the snare of the devil. So, we thank the Lord for the reading of His Word. Let's have a short prayer. Father in heaven, we thank you for this day. We thank you for the time that we will be spending in your text of the scriptures regarding these qualifications of an elder. I pray, Lord, that you will illumine us with your spirit, guide us, so that we could also embody this qualification. In fact, this is not just for the elders, but also for each and every believers of the local church. I pray, Lord, that we may have the grace to continue to walk in holiness and to continue to minister one to another. We thank you, Lord, for this opportunity. Bless every moment we have, even as we have our morning service. This is our prayer in Christ's name. Amen. Okay? So, yan po, no, yung makikita natin dyan. So, in this passage, Paul describes the office of an elder. By the way, napag-aralan na natin to last Sunday, no, yung elder, bishop, and pastors are referring to the same man of God. No? So, Paul describes the office of an elder using the term episkopos, which means overseer or bishop. No? So, at sa ating King James, we have there the bishop. No? In other texts, it's overseer. Ayan. So, through the Old Testament, the terms elder and overseer refer to the same office as well as the word pastor. No? So, nakita na natin yan sa Acts chapter 20 and then sa 1 Peter. No? Yung mga teksto na yan. No? Okay, so yan yung mga texts na pwede nating i-repair. So, yung Titus 1, that's another text for the qualification of elders. And then we could see here on Acts 20, yan yung makikita natin yung tatlo. No, yung pastor as a verb form, and then you have your to have an oversight, to have overseer. No, yan naman yung bishop, referring to the elders of the Ephesian church. No, also yung mga pagbati sa Philippians 1:1, no, elders and deacons. No, of course also in 1 Peter chapter 5 and 1 Timothy chapter 5. So all of these are the texts that we could use to look into the qualifications or the characteristics of an elder. So in this passage, Paul presents a series of qualifications for men. Take notes, for men, it's not for women or ladies. No, sorry to tell, but the calling for the pastor as a Baptist, no, titingnan natin yan sa ating Baptist distinctives, lalo na dun sa two offices, ay sa mga lalaki. No, it's never for ladies to preach or to have authority over the congregation. They may have leadership ministry for women or for children. No? So, yan yung kanilang scope ng ministry ng mga kababaihan. Ngunit ang pagpapastor o pagiging obispo ay maliwanag. This is an explicit text na makikita natin at yung mga explicit na pagbabawal sa mga kababaihan na magsalita sa mixed congregation. So, mahalaga yan na dapat nating makita. No, so, we could list them one by one and I suppose no, we could all see the meaning of this. No? Through, makikita natin dito yung listing niya sa modern translation. No? This is quoted in the English Standard Version. But we will still cross-reference it to our King James text, no? So, yung makikita natin. So, yung word na above reproach, by the way, yung sa verse 1, makikita natin dyan yung sabi dyan, this is a true saying. So, it's actually a word, the same sense na sinabi ni ng Panginoon mismo, verily, verily, I say unto you. Or, amen, amen. So, parang ganyan yung sense nung sinasabi ni Pablo dito. When he say, this is a true saying. Or sometimes, he call it, this is a trustworthy statement na sinasabi patungkol sa mga nagdi-desire. So, if any man desire, no? Or aspire. So, sabi dyan sa Greek term, when you say desire or aspire, it reaches for that particular office or set his heart or ang kanilang mga puso on this particular office. This tell me that a modern emphasis on the necessity of an OT type call from God to the ministry may be too limiting. No? So yung sabi ko kanina, yung component na between man and God, no? That's too limiting. No? Sinasabi ni Pablo dito, a desire to be a church leader is sufficient and the desires of the believer's heart are from the Lord. No? So, kaya nag-set si Pablo ng mga qualification para makita rin ng tao doon sa text at ma-recognize ang tao ng congregation, ng lalaki ng Diyos. So, yun yung makikita natin dyan. Okay. So, the first qualification must be blameless or in modern English rendition, it's above reproach. No? Marami akong nakikitang mga ano dito eh. Mga katoto natin na pag blameless daw ay less blame, no? So parang binaliktad lang, no? At hindi natin nakita yung kahulugan nito. No, as I look at the mounts, no? So it's beyond reproach or unblameable. No, yan yung makikita nating definition nito. Sabi ni Tyler, lexicon, not apprehended, that cannot be laid hold of, that cannot be reprehended, not open to censure or irreproachable, no, because of his character, integrity, so etc. No? So this is a key qualification for the entire context of leadership. No? The praise implies no handle for criticism. When you say blameless or above reproach, dapat ay yung mga kritisismo, both from internally, inside the church, and outside, lalo na yung outside, ay hindi ito, it won't be a matter of discussion. Kapag sinabing si Pastor Randy ay, halimbawa, may nagchismoso sa labas na babaero, halimbawa si Pastor Randy, alam naman natin hindi, it won't be, doesn't make sense. No, walang case for that. No, because Pastor Randy is above reproach or blameless or no handle for criticism. Kumbaga, by that, dun pa lang sa form and substance na tinatawag, dun sa pagkakaso, dun pa lang sa form ay wala na, lagpak na. So, hindi na ititingnan yung substance. No, how much more with the substance? Walang substance. No? So, this is applicable for both the church internally and externally, both for the believing and the unbelieving community, no, yung makikita natin dito. But of course, there is no perfect leaders, no. What's important here are the leaders of the church are godly, respectable, and acceptable believers, no. So ito yung mga katangian na makikita natin sa hindi lang less blame, kasi may blame pa rin yun eh. Pag sinabing blameless or above reproach, yung chismis pa lang, lalagpak pa lang dun sa pinto ng church, ay wala na. It will be nullified because it's false, doesn't have form and substance. No? So, yun yung ibig sabihin nun. No? Unlike kung ang chismis, kung meron siyang katotohanan, ay maaaring ma-question yung integrity ng pastor. O leader. So dapat ang kaya lang talaga maingat ang isang pinuno ng iglesia, no? Because he must be above reproach or blameless. Okay. So this is another qualification na makikita natin. Maraming tanong dito. So you could also pin your message here directly at the Baptist Ministerial Seminary. Huwag kayong matakot na pasukin yon kasi sa atin din yon. No? That's our seminary page na ating ginawa para ma-broadcast natin ito ng live. Okay? Okay, husband of one wife. So, napaka-importante nito na mayroon yung tanong, Brother Ed, ang isa bang binata ay pwedeng magpastor? Yes. Eh, mababailate niya ba yung husband of one wife? No. Because the idea of having a husband or a husband of one wife is what we call marital integrity. Now, because in the Jewish traditions, assume that the leader of the synagogue is a husband of one wife. No? So, na-imply yan dito. Pero, katulad ni Pablo, wala namang masasabi na asawa si Pablo. No? Ang Panginoon mismo ay hindi rin na nag-asawa. So, are they violating these qualifications? Of course not. No? Hindi natin na masasabi yan. But, a more important concept here is marital integrity. No? Kung binata ka, how will you apply marital integrity? Dapat wala kang sexual relation sa ibang babae kung ikaw ay single. That is telling that you are having a marital integrity or sexual integrity. Pag ikaw naman may asawa, dapat sa isang asawa lang. No? So hindi nalalabag ng pagkabinata yung husband of one wife because the concept here is marital integrity. Of course, maraming issue dyan. Di natin matalakay isa-isa. No? But that's the general concept of husband of one wife. No? Yung ating, at maraming mga issues dyan. No? So, what I'm saying is that the man of God should have marital integrity, whether he's a single or a married man. No? Yun yung basic na makikita natin dito. So, sabi nga ni Utley, this is obviously refers to a family relationship. Any problem in the area of family relationship disqualifies one from leadership in a local church. No? So, importante yung family relation, particularly for husband and wife. No? So, ayan, marami kasing mga issue dito, no? Na may kita, but we cannot discuss here. No? So, the general concept of an elder that is a husband of one wife is marital integrity. Now, if you are single, you don't have any sexual relationship with others, with lady. Now, if you are a married man, you should have only one wife. No? So, yun yung makikita natin dyan. So, actually, maraming tanong dito. No? Pwede kong sagutin yan dun sa ating comment box ng ating seminary. Okay. Another is sober-minded or vigilant. No, yung sober-mindedness na tinatawag. Okay, no, so yung ating husband of one wife, vigilant. Makikita natin dito sa King James now the other concept of this sober-mindedness or temperate. Ayan. Yun yung other concept nito based doon sa Mount's Greek dictionary. Abstain from, in respect to wine. No, pag in-apply siya sa wine, meron siyang abstinent, no, circumspect, self-controlled, no. So these are by the way, wag niyo ma-confuse dun sa sober dun sa vigilant, no. I'm still discussing vigilant, no, kasi maraming mga synonymous terms, no. of things free from all wine, no, in an application to alcoholism, dapat he abstained from all wine as vessels, no, etc. So yun yung makikita natin diyan. So to be sober because of alcohol use mentioned in verse 3, no, makikita natin yan sa verse 3 yung paggamit ng alcohol. So to be vigilant or to be sober minded or temperate in its application to alcohol mentioned on verse 3. But this probably refers to a metaphorical use of the term meaning to be sensible, no, to be sensible. And then the self-controlled, no? So the other terms for self-controlled is prudent, no? Discreet, no? Also sober-minded. So medyo may synonym siya, no? So this term in Greek means balance, no? It was used of someone of sound mind, no? Related terms are also found in other verses. It also means sensible, no, or to bring into one sense the meaning, or to encourage, or the other term here is to disciple, or to be prudent, or to be thoughtful. Ayan, so yun yung mga terms na dapat nating makita ang katangian. In fact, lahat ng ito, kung tutuusin, ay sinabi rin ni Pablo sa mga mananampalataya, hindi lamang sa leaders ng church. Baka isipin kasi natin, Brother Ed, hindi naman ako di-desire ng pagkapastor. So, exempted ako sa mga qualification na ito. That's wrong because maling diwa yan dahil ito rin naman ay makikita natin inuutos ni Pablo o ine-exhort ni Pablo sa ibang mga talata ng scriptures. No, maliban na lamang doon sa teaching qualification. No, aside from the teaching qualification, lahat ng ito na bababanggit, dapat qualification din ito ng bawat mananampalataya. So walang exempted sa atin na i-harness ito, i-cultivate itong mga bagay na ito sa ating buhay. No? So yun yung makikita natin dyan. Okay. So, yung self-control there is sober. Okay. Respectable or good behavior. No? Yung, if you look at the King James text, of good behavior. No? Of good behavior yan. It's used also in Titus, no? On a negative sense, but on a positive sense in Timothy. So, implies proper order or decorum. May kaayusan. No? That which is a proper, respected. No? Dahil may kaayusan, ang taong ito ay siya'y rinirespeto. At inaasahan yung kaayusan na to ng local congregation, expected by the local society. Therefore, this is an aspect of a good reputation with those outside of the church, lalo na. So, meron kang naka-establish ka ng rapport, perhaps, good reputation. You have a good behavior in the context of the outside environment. Okay. Hospitality. Given to hospitality or hospitable. So, kasi sa panahon ni Pablo, marami yung mga houses of prostitutions. Kaya, hindi pumupunta doon yung mga itinerant preachers and teachers, no? They're actually dwelling into the house of a brother or a Christian, no? Dapat ang isang pastor ay dapat hospitable, no? Given to hospitality. So kasi nga during those times, marami yung prostitution din eh sa nung panahon ni Pablo. Kaya nag-iingat itong mga itinerant preachers at most of the time they will dwell into the house of a fellow laborer in Christ. No? Yun yung makikita natin dyan. So, therefore, Christians, especially Christian leaders, had to have their homes open for itinerant missionaries and for the needy of the community. So, bubuksan natin ang ating mga tahanan sa mga nangangailangang mga mangangaral at doon sa mga needy. May mga pangangailangan sa komunidad, lalo na yung mga physical, practical aspects of the community ay atin itong pinagkakalob. At ito rin ay katangian na dapat ay makita sa isang pinuno. Hindi lamang ng pinuno, but also every one of us, that we become hospitable. Okay, able to teach. Ito siguro yung magdi-distinguish sa mga leaders, sa Christian leaders, sa isang Kristiyano, no? No? Leaders are to be able teachers, no? Able to teach, no? Sabi diyan sa King James, apt to teach. Okay? It's interesting that teaching is listed as a separate gift. No, yung mga teaching gifts na makikita natin sa 1 Corinthians, nandiyan 'yan. But linked to the gift of a pastor in Ephesians chapter 4. No, makikita natin yung mga kaugnayan niyan. Apparently there were teachers, but also all pastors have to be able to function in this area. So walang pastor na hindi marunong magturo. Hindi ko alam sa ibang mga church communities, no? Ay mayroon silang mga admin pastors. Pastor pero hindi nagtuturo. No, supervise lang kung anong gagawin ng mga preaching pastors. Nakakatawa, pastor at walang teaching ministry. No? Parang oxymoron 'yon kasi maliwanag nga sa mga teksto na 'to na dapat may teaching skills, apt to teach. No, or hina-harness niya yung teaching qualities niya. No? Ina-apply niya 'to sa preaching niya. Sa pangangaral ng salita ng Diyos. No? So, in the sense of all gifted persons, Ephesians chapter 4, are proclaimers of the gospel, but in different sense and with different emphasis. Yan. Some Bible scholars interpret this qualification as reference to a well-trained or educated people, or possibly those who are teachable. No, teachable dapat. Paano ka nakapagturo? Kasi natuto ka. No? Hindi ka naman... Sa linggo nga ng computers, IT, garbage in, garbage out. Meaning, how will you teach the congregation if you have not studied the text of the scriptures or have not learned something from other sources? No? Ayan. So, dapat ay teachable. Finally, this ability to teach must be related to the false teachers who thought they were the teachers of the law, but they were self-deceived. So, yan din yung isa sa mga katangian ng mga kulto. Ayaw magpaturo niyan. Na minsan nga, may kumakatok dito ng JW. Meron daw siyang gospel, no? Sabi ko, sige Brad. Sis pala, sis. Ay, bago ka magsalita, ako muna magle-lecture sa'yo. No, ayaw magpaturo. Gusto lang nila tanggapin yung kanilang false gospel. Pero yung gospel ng Panginoon, ayaw nilang pakinggan. O ayaw nilang ma-expose yung kamalian ng kanilang pagkakulto. So, maraming kumakatok-katok. So, uuwi na lang sila. No, so, yun. So, yan ay contrast din sa katangian ng mga cultic churches, yung mga pinuno nila. Ayaw magpaturo yun kung ano yung dogma nila. Yun na yun. That's it. So, marami tayong ganyang mga kulto, cultic leaders. No? Yung katangian nila. No? Hindi mo matuturuan yan. No? Wala nang dagdag knowledge. Sila na yung ultimate source of knowledge ng kanilang church. But for us to have a faithful leader in the church, we must be able to teach. We become teachable. Teachable tayo. Continuing pa rin yung ating pag-aaral ng salita ng Diyos, yung ating improvement sa mga bagay na ito. Okay. Not a drunkard or not given to wine, no? So isa pang or not addicted to wine, not given to wine, not drunkard, must not be drunkard, no? So yan yung mga makikita natin diyan. No? Sabi nga ni Dr. Utley, it seems to be an allusion from the Septuagint in Proverbs 23, no? But we will not read it anymore, but it must be re-emphasized that the Bible rails against drunkenness, no? Yun yung makikita natin dyan, no? So yun yung importante na makita natin ito. Sorry po, saglit lang mga kapatid. Meron lang ako. I-reconfigure dito. Okay. So, yan. Marami kasing ongoing seminars ngayon, no? So, I need to pause for a while to reconfigure my attendance doon, no? But later pa naman yon. Medyo nagpasimula lang. Okay. So, importante yan, no? Yung ating attitude behind alcoholism. So, importante yan. So, hindi pwedeng magpastor pag ikaw ay lasinggero. Yun yung pinakasimpleng mga pahayag dito. Huh? So, it may not have this concept of complete abstinence. So, total abstinence comes from an individual commitment of believers to the Lord based on limiting their personal freedoms. So, but because of the culture in which they minister. So, yung ating commitment, no? Lalo na kung ikaw ay mangangaral, isa sa mga leaders ng church, dapat yung it's on our liberty, Christian liberty, not to engage with alcoholism. No. Yun yung dapat, kasi definitely you will be compromised, no? Hindi pwedeng lasing ang isang mangangaral, no? Imagine nyo, may akyat na mangangaral sa pulpito, lasing. No? So hindi po yan magandang patotoo. Okay. I need to go on, move on, not violent but gentle, no? So this not striker. No, not striker. Okay, hindi siya striker up to strike while not violent person. Ayan, yun yung mga, or pugnacious. Now, when you say pugnacious, literally not a striker. It may be related to the use of abuse of alcohol as it effects. No? So, yung epekto ng alcohol, pwede natin i-connect dito. No? Normally, mga lasinggero, nagiging violent yan eh. No? Violent. As it all affects all interpersonal relationship. The family, of course, pag may lasing, no? The house church, suray-suray si pastor sa ano. Tapos si Joey ang aakay kay halimbawa kay Pastor Lem, no? Halimbawa lang naman, no? So hindi talaga magandang ano, no? Picture ng isang pinuno. And of course, yung mga false teachers, marami ng butas kay pastor. Ay, ito pa lang kahinaan ni pastor, isang ano lang, isang bilog lang. No? So he become violent. But be gentle, no? So meron tayong kahinahunan. Not quarrelsome, no? Ayan, importante rin 'yan, no? Dapat hindi siya. So not quarrelsome, this refers to a loving reasonableness which is prepared to yield to others, describe a kind, gentle person, no? In terms of your relation one to another. So hindi konting ano lang ng halimbawa na yung ilong nahawakan lang ano agad, away gulo, no? Hindi ganun dapat. No, it needs to be gentle, peaceable. Ayan, isa pang katangian, no? Quarrelsome, not lover of money. Or not greedy or filthy lucre. Free from the love of money, not covetous, not a lover of money, he must not love money. Ayan. So it's actually a compound word for silver and brotherly love, which is equals to not a lover of money. So this is another characteristic of a false teacher, kasi ang mga false teacher, ang gusto lang ay yung pera ng kongregasyon. No, yun. Okay, so as we continue, a good manager of his household, the one that ruleth well his own house. Ayan, leadership can be seen at home. No, any kind of difficulty between husband and wife or children or grandparents or in-laws was a basis for disqualification in this early church setting. No, kaya nga no handle for criticism eh, yung being an above reproach, no, is the main concern. How one rules his home will show one's tendency in leading the church. So yon yung makita natin diyan. So ayan, kailangan importante yung become a good manager of household. Okay, definitely not a novice, no? Hindi dapat novice. Not a new convert, no? Ano, kaka-convert lang nung isang linggo eh gusto na magpastor ngayon. So hindi pwede 'yon, no? Yung dapat yung congregation, sa congregation pa lang hindi na 'yon eh. Hindi na, ay brother, kailangan mo munang mag-discipleship program. O kaya brother, pumunta ka muna sa Youth Bible Study. Mag-aral kayo ni Brother Ed. No? Hindi agad pastor, no? Ayan, so dapat hindi siya bago, hindi siya baguhan. So perhaps ay tagaan na sa panahon, no? Ibig sabihin in terms of the grace of the Lord, no? Ay siya ay lumago sa paglilingkod sa Panginoon, ang biyaya ng Panginoon nasa kanya, salita ng Panginoon, patuloy siyang binibuild up, no, in terms of progressive sanctification, then eventually ay makita natin yung kanyang kakayahan na mamuno. Pero hindi recent convert dapat. Not a novice. Well thought of by the outsiders, no? So this again, another concept of being above reproach. Yung ating or yung sa King James, he must be a good report of them which are without. So yung above reproach ay inulit dito. Must have a good reputation. The leaders must be viewed as honest and genuine by the unbelieving community by which the church is trying to bring to faith in Christ. So, importante yun. Yung naiisip din ng unbelieving community. Okay? Okay. I think I need to wrap up. So, meron na lang tayong, meron pa naman tayong more than 10 minutes. So, we could still look into this, no? So, diniscuss ko lang, maganda rin yung summary dito ni Dr. Bob Utley sa mga talatang ito. So, siguro isasama ko rin siya as part of my attachment to these lectures, no, later sa ating group chat. Okay. So, alam na natin, maidea na tayo, no, no? Dito sa above reproach, is to have consistently godly character that is not open to charge of living in any serious overt sin. Lalo na yung mga sexual sins, and this scandalous sins, no, dapat ay walang makikitang ganyan, no, meaning our character is consistently godly, no, kahit within, from within or from without, doon sa external community or the unbelieving community, makikita rin na that the man of God is above reproach because of his godly character. But doesn't mean perfection, no, so hindi perfect, but more on its consistency, faithfulness, no, na pagpo-progress ng kanyang character. So all Christian still struggle with sin, definitely, but to be an elder, a man must have consistently, thoroughly godly character. So talagang meron kang excuse me lang po ah. Meron kang pagpapagal at nais, no, na ikaw ay magpatuloy sa kabanalan, no? So yung guarding one to another. Okay. So, yan po yung above reproach, no? Number three, the Greek phrase translated husband of one wife could also be translated as one woman man. Okay? So, importante yun. Kaya ngayon, in-emphasize natin kanina yung marital integrity in the relation. No? What does this qualification require of a married man? So, all Christians, no? Yan. But, to be an elder, a man must have a consistently, thoroughly godly character, no? Of course, it doesn't mean that this verse requires a man to be married. After all, Paul commends singleness for the purpose of the ministry. So, rather, since the vast majority of men marry, this verse simply assumes that and asserts that an elder must be sexually faithful or has marital integrity. Obviously, a single man who would be an elder must have this sexual integrity as well. So, yan yung ating tinatalakay. No? So, whether you're a married man or single, no, you must have sexual integrity. How about sober-mindedness, self-controlled and respectable? All have referred to a similar quality on verse 2, no? So, wala na tayong time to list, no? So, but I already explained some of this sa verse 2. Number 5, why do you think hospitality is a qualification for an elder? No, nasabi na rin natin yan. So, because it demonstrates generous care for others, no? So, yung pangangailangan ng bawat isa, lalo na yung mga itinerant preacher during the time of Paul, as well as those who are needy in the community. So, Christian hospitality should consist of welcoming fellow Christian to one's home, especially Christians who are in need. No? It should involve providing fellow Christians material need as well as spiritual need. No? Yun din dapat yung makita sa, hindi lang sa mga pastor, but also in every believers in Christ. Sabi nga ni Don Carlson, observe that perhaps the most extraordinary thing about biblical qualification for elder is that they are not all that extraordinary. In fact, most of them are required of all Christian elsewhere in the New Testament. No, na-observe ni Don Carson ito na, as I was saying to you, na lahat ng qualification ito ay hindi extraordinary characteristics. These are characteristics of every believers in Christ. No? At yan, makikita natin yung mga cross-reference, no? So, apart from not being a new convert, of course, definitely is not a novice, the one qualification that is not required of all Christian elsewhere is that elder must be able to teach or apt to teach. So, yan yung isang makikita natin, yung teaching skills ng isang man of God. Okay, as we read on shortly on Titus chapter 1, verse 9 and 10, this is actually a cross-reference to the text that we have read, Titus chapter 1, verse 9 and 10. Okay. Parang ano, I will be looking into verse 5, Titus verse 5, 1, verse 5. Verse 6, if any be blameless, a husband of one wife, having faithful children, not accused of riot or unruly, for a bishop must be blameless as a steward of God, not self-willed, not soon angry, not given to wine, no striker, not given to filthy lucre, but lover of hospitality, a lover of good men, sober, just, holy, temperate, holding fast the faithful word as he had been taught, that he may be able by sound doctrine both exhort and convince gainsayer. So exhortation applies to the believers in Christ, the congregation, and then yung contradict those who oppose is for the false teaching na pwedeng pumasok sa church. No? So yun yung makita nating dual function ng pangangaral ng salita ng Diyos. So able to teach so that they will be able to instruct the church the truth and to refute those who contradict, meaning the false doctrine. Okay? So, tingnan na lang natin to. In 1 Timothy 2:12, Paul write, I do not permit woman to teach, no? Or to exercise authority over man. So, maliwanag yan. Kaya yung mga girls sa atin, mga sisters, wag na kayong mag-desire na maging pastor dahil yan ay, alam ko naman na alam nyo. No? Pero, pinapaalala lang natin mula sa salita ng Panginoon. No? Kasi, sooner or later, no, yung mga kultong yan, mag-i-evolve. No? Ngayon, pinapayagan na. Gender equality daw to. No, it's not an issue of gender equality. No, it's an issue whether the scripture says so or not. Or the scripture prohibits it, no? So in this case, there's prohibition for women to teach or to exercise authority over men. And he grounds his command not in the cultural context or custom or temporary circumstance, but in creation itself, no? So Paul is appealing to creation, no? Indicating that this is normative, ongoing teaching for all churches, no? Even in the modern church, whether there is so much pragmatism and relativism and what we call other thoughts na makita natin, no, ay still the same. Women are not to teach and to have authority over men. So in the light of the fact that authoritative teaching is a key responsibility of elders, this means that scripture does not permit women to serve as elders. Rather, only qualified men should fit the role. Eh, Brother Ed, mayroong PhD in theology, si sister. Tapos, may mga qualification naman. No? Of course, the congregation should not recognize that because it violates the scriptures, the word of God. No? So, tatandaan natin yun. Okay, so how about this one? No, yung mga related context ng alcoholism, no? Not a drunkard, not violent but gentle, quarrelsome, not a lover of money. No, kasi nga yung isa rin sa implication ng palainom ay ano rin 'yan, talagang ang implication niyan mag-aalat siya ng amount for just to drink, no? Lalo na yung mga mahal na inumin, no? Yung napapanood natin diyan sa mga commercials ay talagang you need to have a lot of money just to drink this special brandy perhaps, no? So, yan, may relation siya. Ayan, is to have in common is that they all refer to self-control and to mastery of appetites, no? So, appetite mo, no? You need to have control. No, you need to be temperate in all these things, no? May mga control tayo sa mga extreme appetites. No, yung isang example dito yung alcoholism, no? Extreme appetite sa kung anumang bagay ay dapat may control tayo diyan. No? So a man who isn't drunkard control his use of alcohol. Okay? So, mahirap talagang kontrolin yan, lalo na pag nakainom ka na, no? So, yung diferensya ng nakainom at lasing, mahirap talaga i-distinguish yan. Paiba-iba yan. Depende sa ininom mo, depende sa condition mo, kung gutom ka, ubusog, no? Or other things, no? So, better not try one, no? If you cannot control, no? So, yun yung makita nating concept nito. Mas wise na wag ka nang tumikim kung hindi mo naman kayang kontrolin. No? Alright. A man who is not violent but gentle controls his desire for revenge or honor and instead humble himself to serve someone else in love. Yan. So, syempre, importante yan na that the man of God needs to be gentle, not violent. No, hindi maraming gwardiya tapos eh papabugbog yung oopo sa kanya, no? So hindi dapat ganun. And a man who is not a lover of money, yan, has a master of desire for material things. So hindi yan yung prioridad niya, yung magpayaman, magpadami ng imperyo, no? In terms of material things, hindi dapat ganyan ang ultimate desire ng isang mananampalataya, lalo na ng binalal ng Diyos, no? He has come to treat money and the possessions as God's gifts. Kaya gagamitin niya ito sa gawain, gagamitin niya ito para sa church, no? Entrusted to him so that he would use them faithfully rather than committing them and hoarding them. No? So magamit talaga sa gawain ng Panginoon lahat ng mga pinagkakaloob in terms of gifts, tithes and offerings, etc. So why does Paul insist that a man must manage, no? Napaliwanag na natin ito because a man's home life is one that truest tests his character. No, yung kung ano yung management niya sa bahay, yan magre-reflect sa management niya sa church, no? So a man lives with his wife and children every day and he is responsible before God to lead them spiritually. So yung spiritual need din ng tahanan. Whether a man's children obey him is a test of how well he teaches them, disciplines them, and models godly living for them. Importante din, ha? Lalo na tayo, mga ama ng tahanan, na kailangan magkaroon tayo ng pananagutan na sila ituruan, disiplinahin, at maging ehemplo sa kabanalan para sa ating buong pamilya. Thus, if a man is godly leader, it will be evident in his home life. No, importante 'yon. Kaya kailangan maayos din yung ating tahanan. And if he's not, it will be evident in his home life. That's why Paul says, if someone does not know how to manage his own house, how will he take care for God's church? So, 'yan, mahalagang paisipan sa atin, no? So, I think this is my last question. Medyo ano na tayo. Why would a recent convert, okay, bakit nga ba yung ating mga novice, no? Sabi dyan sa talata, becoming pop up with conceit and falling into condemnation. Kasi baguhan nga eh. So, medyo maano pa siya. Malalansi pa siya, no? Mauuto pa kasi nga convert eh. New convert eh. So, hindi dapat tayo mag-elect ng isang pastor, no? New convert. No, because he has not developed the kind of tested character. Yan, kailangan matest muna yung character niyan that comes truly, through faithfully following the Lord over a long period of time. If a new convert is put into a position of prominence as an elder, he's likely to let privilege go into his head. Yan, pupunta lang sa ulo lahat ng mga pamuno, no, yung privilege of leadership rather than the responsibility. He may be likely to begin to think of himself more highly than he ought to think. And as the scripture teaches, pride goes before the fall. Ayan. Thus, an elder must be someone whose character and maturity have tested and proved through a relatively long course of following the Lord Jesus Christ. So, dapat may haba ng panahon. Relative naman yan, pero hindi months or days lang, but could take years, no, before makita natin yung leadership character ng isang tao. Okay. So what at stake in verse 7 in an elder's reputation among non-Christian is the reputation of Christ in the world. So bit-bit ng isang leader ng iglesia, yung reputasyon ng Panginoon sa mga hindi mananampalataya. Kaya kailangan maingatan natin ito. No? All Christians are called to represent Christ as ambassadors of Christ to the world and to commend the gospel for their good deeds. All Christians bear the name of Christ, no? Elders, since they are officially recognized leaders of the church, have special responsibility and heightened visibility before the world. Mas lalo na sa mga leaders ng iglesia. The world will look first to the church leaders to see if they live according to what they are teaching. If a church leader are hypocrites, they discredit the gospel and the church in the eyes of the world. Yan yung nagiging problema ngayon. No? So ito are just reflection questions na makikita natin. No? So pwede nyo nang basahin yan. So these are more or less the qualifications of a church leader based on 1 Timothy chapter 3 and cross-reference to Titus chapter 1. No? So yun yung makikita natin. I don't know if there are questions popping up the so far wala pa namang ano, no. So tatapusin na natin ito. So lecture 6-5, pupunta naman tayo dun sa mga deacons, no, servants of the church. Okay? So these are the texts, Acts chapter 3 Acts chapter 6 verse 1 to 7 and then continuing in Timothy verses 8 to 13. So yan po yung ating babasahin. Okay, medyo overtime na ako, no? I think I need to sign out now to give way to our Pasig ministry. Salamat po sa pagkakataon na makapaglingkod tayo sa Panginoon at sa bawat isa sa mga kapatiran. So I'll be uploading the material this afternoon. See you po sa ating morning service as well as our youth Bible study and PM Bible study or service as well. So magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat.
Kings and kingdoms will all pass away, but this.